Good morning, students. Today, we are going ahead with the story, The Gift of Chappals, from where we left in our last lecture. In the first part of the story, we have read that Mridu went to her aunt Rukmani's house. There, she met her cousins, Meena, Ravi, and Lali. Mridu saw that Lali was learning violin with her music teacher. Her music teacher was fairly well off, as he wore a gold chain and a diamond ring. He was bold-headed and bony figure. The music teacher's notes seemed to float up and settle perfectly into the visible tracks of melody. But Lali was not able to play on the violin perfectly. Then Beggar came to the garden of the house. Rukmani asked Ravi to send the beggar away, as he had coming here every day. So the beggar sat in the garden. Then Beggar came to the garden of the house. Rukmani asked Ravi to send the beggar away, as he was coming here every day. When the beggar came, he sat in the garden for rest. The beggar said that he had blisters on his feet because of hot sun that made the tar melted on the road. That's the reason why he was here in the garden. He showed pink peeling blisters on the soles of his bare feet to the children. Seeing the beggar's large pink peeling blisters on his bare feet, the children concluded that he had no money to buy a chappal. Then Mridu suggested that they should give the chappals to the beggar. The children started searching for the chappals. They found one in the veranda. They did not know whose chappal was that. Ravi picked up and went to the garden to give the chappals to the beggar. Dropping the chappals in front of the old man, Ravi asked the beggar to wear these chappals and not to come back again. The beggar stared at the slippers, hurriedly flung his towel over his shoulder, and in a minute he vanished at the corner of the street. As the children have given the chappals without asking anyone, Mridu knew that somebody might ask slippers from them. So he left the house hurriedly. Now it's a question hour session. So here will be some questions in front of you and you have to answer. Question number one is, who among the following is not the character in the story? Your options are, option number one, Chavi; option number two, Meena; option number three, Mridu; and option number four, Ravi. And the right answer for you is Chavi. Question number two for you is, how can you say that the music teacher was fairly well off? And the options for you are, number one, as he was bold-headed and bony figure; option number two, as he wore a gold chain and a diamond ring; option number three, his notes seemed perfectly well; option number four, none of the above. And the right option is, as he wore a gold chain and a diamond ring. Question number three, who was given instructions to send away the beggar? And the option for you are, number one, Rukmani was given instructions by Ravi. Ravi was given instructions by Rukmani. Meena was given instruction by Tapi. And Mridu was given instructions by Thapa. And the right option is, Ravi was given instruction by Rukmani. Your next question is, why were the children searching the old chappals? And the option for you is, number one, because Meena lost her chappals; number two, they wanted to give it to the beggar; number three, because Rukmani needed; and number four, none of the above. And the right option for you is, they wanted to give it to the beggar. Now it's a time for some more questions. You'll be given some questions and you have to write the answers for those questions. Question number one is, what make the children to conclude that the beggar has no money to buy chappals? Question number two, on getting chappals, the beggar vanished in a minute. Why was he in such a hurry to leave? This is all for this session. Thank you very much, and we will meet again in the next session.